drought is hurting more than just our lawn.
All summer, we were showing you water main breaks, too many to count. Today, News 5's Brian Hamrick found out the drought could be the culprit, and it's not just affecting water lines.
Well, we've had weeks on end of incredibly dry weather, which, ironically, is why some people have been having trouble with floods.
The ripple effect of the drought extends beyond the shades of evaporated brown.
Look at the grass. You can tell that it's hot.
From the surface to a deeper level where extreme dry conditions are signaled like this. With extreme amounts of water. It's a parched paradox. As the number of days with little or no rain increases, so does the number of water main breaks.
Water was gushing everywhere.
The latest in Springfield Township, this break on DeSoto was no fountain of youth. What was flowing? Frustration, adding up in hours.
12, 13, 14, plus 8, 23 hours without water. You know what I'm saying? We got jobs, kids.
Just this week, a break on Town Street in Roselawn, one day after another in Glendale, and then one a month ago that made Union Township look more like Yellowstone Township. Why all of this now?
We're, you know, many inches below what our normal average is supposed to be for the year, and all that water comes out of the ground and you don't have enough replenishing it, and the clay soils in particular will shrink.
Jason Sander with HC Nutting says clay is prominent here. As the ground shrinks around the water mains, that takes away the support of the pipes, allowing them to break and creating cracks in the patience of those who live near them.
Yeah, there's no way to predict when or where we'll see the next water main break, but until we get some rain, we probably haven't seen the last of them. Brian Hamrick, News 5.